Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of Java JDK on a Windows operating system. So let's begin. Now to install the latest version of Java on your Windows operating system, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and in the address bar, just simply search with JDK download, then enter. And you'll be seeing this Java downloads is basically our first search result. So just simply click on that and it will going to redirect you to this Java downloads official site. And here if you scroll down, you can see that Java IC development kit, that is JDK, is available for download and our latest version is 18.0.1.1. Okay, so if you want to install Java 17, that also you can do, which is not recommended unless you are doing any project which is, you know, where Java 17 only it supports. So for that you need to download Java 17, or otherwise if you are new to Java and you want to learn Java, so I'll be recommending you to download the latest version, which is Java 18. And here you can see that it has three options. One is Linux, macOS and Windows. So depending upon what operating system you use, you should, you know, switch to those tabs. I am using Windows, so I'm going to switch to Windows. And no matter what Windows operating system you use, 10 or 11, you can always, you know, download anything from this Windows tab. Okay, so here I'm going to download this, you know, MSI installer, which is basically Microsoft installer x64. So I'm just going to click on this and it will going to start downloading our Java. Now since I have already downloaded it, I just, you know, simply cancel it and I'll just simply go to my download directory and you can see that same file is already been downloaded over here. Now to install, you need to just simply double click on it and it will going to redirect you to this Java IC development kit 18.0.1. So let us first minimize our download directory and our browser as well. And here just, you know, simply click on next. And this is going to be our installation destinations, that is the C program files, Java JDK 18.0.1. So you can, you know, keep this as a default, otherwise you can always change by just, you know, simply clicking on this change button and you are going to set a new directory where your Java going to be installed. So you can do that, but I'll be recommending you, you know, to keep this all default. Why change unnecessarily? Okay, so and then just simply click on next. And it will going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. And see, our download has rightly started. Sorry, our installation has rightly started. So this will take some time, maybe, you know, a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back right after completion of this process. Yeah. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see that our Java IC development kit 18.0.1.1 is rightly installed. So just, you know, simply click on close. So now that our Java is rightly installed, it's time to set our environment path. This is very important, guys. So for that, you need to just simply click on the search icon and here just simply search with environ and you'll be getting this edit the system environment variables. So just simply click on that and it will going to pop up this system properties page. So here you'll be getting these environment variables. So just simply click on that and it will going to open this environment variables window. So here under the system variables, you need to set your Java path over here. So for that, first simply click on path and then just simply click on edit. And what it will do is it will going to open this edit environment variable window. Here you need to just simply click on new. And here we are supposed to paste the Java installation path. So how to get that path? So for that, you need to just simply, you know, go to your C drive, then go to your program files, and then Java, and then you'll be seeing this Java JDK 18.0.1 rightly created over here. So just, you know, simply go inside that folder, then bin folder, and now you need to just, you know, simply click on this address bar, then right click on it and copy. That's all. Now just simply minimize it and here again just simply click on new and then right click on it and paste the path. Okay, so C program files, Java JDK, then the version number, then slash bin, that will be the path. Okay, then now just simply click on OK and you can see that path will be directly set over here. Now it's time to set our Java home as well. So for that, just simply click on new and here just simply type Java underscore home and here under variable value again right click on it. But this time, remember to delete this bin folder, right? You need to just, you know, simply keep it till JDK and then the version number. That's all. Now just simply click on OK. And you can see Java home system variables is directly created over here. Now just simply click on OK. Then again OK. So now that you know that our Java is rightly installed along with the environment path variable is also set, you can test whether Java is properly installed or not. So for that, you need to just simply click on the search icon and here just simply search with CMD. And what it will do is it will going to, you know, give you search result command prompt. So just simply click on that. And you'll be seeing our command prompt rightly opened over here. So here you need to just simply type with Java space dash dash version. Then enter. And you can see that our latest version of Java, that is Java 18.0.1, is rightly installed on our machine. So our Java is rightly installed, our environment path is also set, so that's why you can clearly see this message. Now I'll also show you how to create a simple Hello World program and how to run them. So for that, just simply right click on it and then new folder. Let's give the folder name as a Java practice. And just simply go inside that folder, then right click on it, new, and that text document. And here let's give the text document file name as Hello World, and I'm going to change this extension with Java, right? So just, you know, simply click on yes, and our file extension name is also changed. Just simply double click on it to open the file, and it is rightly open in our notepad. And here just, you know, simply write a simple Hello World program. So first it will be our class, and then we need to create our main method. So public static void main string args, which is an array. And here I'm going to just, you know, simply print system.out.println. I'm going to print Hello World. Right. So public static void main system.println Hello World. Right. So just, you know, simply go to file and save. That's all. Now you need to go to this Java practice directory, and here in the address bar, just simply search with CMD, and it will going to open our command prompt right at this directory, see Java practice. So here you need to first compile your Java program. So for that, just simply type Java C, C for compilation, and then name of our file, which is helloworld.java. So helloworld.java, then enter. And you can see that our program is rightly compiled with no errors. And what it will do is it will going to create our class. See, hello world.class file is generated. Right. So all this basically means is our program is rightly compiled. So it's time to run our program. So how to run? To run, just simply type Java. This time there will be no C because we are just simply running it. And our class name, which is hello world. So hello world. And see, our output hello world is rightly shown in our console. So in this way, you can easily install the latest version of Java on a Windows operating system. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.